Hi, I'm David Lee from BASSBOSS, and you might be watching this because you're thinking about adding a BASSBOSS product to your sound system, or you might be thinking about adding some more BASSBOSS product to your existing BASSBOSS sound system. Let's talk about adding subwoofers. If you already own a BASSBOSS subwoofer and you want to add another 1, 2, 3, or 10, there is no reason not to do that. You can combine any model of BASSBOSS subwoofer with any other model of BASSBOSS subwoofer, and they will be phase coherent. In other words, they will work together and contribute positively, some positively, so you'll get an increase in sound pressure level. When you bring whatever combination of subs you have for whatever need you have in terms of like physical need. I need small subs because I do a lot of events where I want to be able to carry them upstairs or whatever, but I want to have something big. Can I use them together? Yes, you can. You can put them together. They will not cancel each other. They will work together. They will contribute positively to the bass in the room. That is, as far as I know, unique in the market. It takes a lot of planning for that to be incorporated across the product line. And then when you bring your tops, whatever preset, they'll work with those subs in the same way. Put them together, pick the preset combination that you like the sound of. You can't get it wrong. You know, there's always better and worse, and some people like chocolate and some like vanilla, and nobody's wrong. Just pick the ones that sound good to you. But for the most part, you can combine any subwoofer with any other subwoofer and appropriately stack any top on that combination, and everything will work well together. The question that you may need to answer is, what do you need more of? Do you need more deep bass? Do you need more upper bass? Do you need more sound pressure level in general? If you're happy with the range of the system that you're operating, adding more of the same box will just simply add more SPL in that operating range. If you need more deeper extension than what you currently have, you can add a box that has the performance lower than what you currently have, and they will sum together, and you'll be able to extend the low frequency response of your system. Say, for instance, something extreme perhaps, but at least it'll provide an example. A BB15 and a ZV28. Now, it's not that crazy of a combination, because a ZV28 operates in the very, very low frequencies where the BB15 struggles to reach, and the BB15 is comfortable doing the upper bass range that you don't necessarily use the ZV28 for. So if you bring them together, the combination of the BB15, which operates from about 40 hertz on up, with the ZV28, which operates from, say, 23 hertz on up to 80, will result in an increase in SPL where the BB15 is adding to what the ZV28 does. The BB15 can't add anything down in the very bottom end where the ZV28 does its thing. So what you end up with is more output in that upper bass range than if you didn't have the BB15 at all, but not more in that bottom range, that the BB15 will not contribute more output in the very bottom range of where the ZV28 operates. So you end up with more SPL in the range that the BB15 is already delivering, but extending your low frequency capacity. And that is often a very good, desirable thing, particularly if you're doing music where you really have some songs that really push the bottom of the envelope, and you don't necessarily need to carry a giant subwoofer everywhere. So you have the ability to bring them together. You don't have to risk the fact that one's not really helping the other, or you got cancellation for this or that or the other reason. You just set them up. You set your ZV28, for instance, in that context, you'd set your ZV28 in like preset 1, and then you'd set your BB15 in, say, for instance, higher up, preset 6 maybe, and you listen to it and you'd have the combination that you like, and you can combine any of the presets together as long as it's not the cardioid mode preset. When they're both facing the same direction, you want to be using basically 1 through 6 on either one, and they will sum, mix and match until you get the sound that you want. That's the right way to put the boxes together.